Good morning. Welcome to Worship Online. I'm Pastor Maria. Pastor Kiri is off today, and it is Bluegrass Sunday. We're worshiping outdoors at church today, so we've pre-recorded worship for you so you can be part of it if you can't be here. If you are new to our Saviors, we'd love to connect with you. You're invited to fill out a connection card. You can find that on the website under Connect. Also on the website, you'll find a link to the weekly announcements. Two announcements to highlight for you today. Registration for Vacation Bible School is currently open. VBS will be August 5th through 8th, so spread the word and get the young people in your life signed up for that. And also with outdoor worship today, there is no Zoom coffee hour. That will resume next Sunday. With that, we move into a song that serves as our confession and forgiveness today.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sinners, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sinners, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, faithful, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, faithful, let's go down, down in the river to pray.
Let us pray. Good and gracious God, Jesus left a mark on so many during his ministry. When we think of those he healed, we know that healing often meant so much more. As we remember the ways Jesus left a mark on others, we're grateful for the ways he's left a mark on us. May our words and actions be filled with love and mercy, that your love in Jesus might leave a mark through us. Amen. Our scripture today is from the Gospel according to Mark, the 5th chapter. A large crowd followed Jesus and pressed in on him. Now there was a woman who had been suffering from a flow of blood for 12 years. She had endured much under many physicians and had spent all that she had, and she was no better, but rather grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak, for she said, "If I but touch his cloak, I will be made well." Immediately, her flow of blood stopped, and she felt in her body that she was healed of her disease. Immediately aware that power had gone forth from him, Jesus turned about in the crowd and said, "Who touched my cloak?" And his disciples said to him, "You see the crowd pressing in on you. How can you say who touched me?" He looked all around to see who had done it. But the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came in fear and trembling, fell down before him, and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Life is messy, and so often we're trying not to leave a mark. We're careful when we open the car door in a parking lot so we don't scratch the car next to us. When we grab a snack without a plate, we hold our hand under it until we get to the kitchen sink. Then we lean over the sink so the crumbs have somewhere to fall while we eat our snack. When we've been working outside and have dirt on our hands from the garden or oil from a repair project, we come in the house like we're going into surgery, right? We're careful not to leave a mark on a doorknob or a wall or a light switch as we go to wash our hands. Life is messy, so in many ways, we try not to leave a mark. However, there are positive experiences in life that leave a mark on us and shape us into who we are. And there are ways we interact with others that leave a mark on them, changing their lives for the better. Those are the kinds of things we've been lifting up this month in our sermon series called Leave a Mark. We've been looking at Bible stories from the Gospel according to Mark and the ways Jesus left a mark on the people he encountered back then and how he leaves a mark on our lives today. Now, today's Bible story could be considered a messy one. It centers around a woman who's been living with a flow of blood for 12 years. And to be clear, we have no idea what kind of medical diagnosis she would have received these days. We don't know where the blood is or how much blood there is. What we do know is that she's suffered from continuing bleeding. And that medical condition made her ritually unclean under Jewish law. The bleeding would have to stop for at least 7 days for her to be considered clean. So for 12 years, she's been living with this bleeding, which means she has been living in social and religious isolation for 12 long years. We don't know how old she is or whether or not she's married. But if she wanted to get married within those 12 years, she would not have been able to. If she was married before the condition started, her husband could now use her medical condition as a grounds for divorce if he wanted to. Being ritually unclean was incredibly isolating in every way. She wasn't allowed to touch anyone, and no one was allowed to touch her, or else they would become unclean for a period of time too. Think of how often you've drawn strength from a hug, or a hand on your shoulder, or a squeeze of the hand. This woman could have none of those things. No one could offer her comfort with a touch, and she was unable to offer comfort to anyone else with a touch. This condition kept her away from family, from friends, and from her entire community. She spent everything she had trying to find a solution with doctors, but she didn't improve. In fact, we're told she got worse over time. This woman was suffering and was very alone. After 12 years of living like this, she hears about Jesus. She hears that he's a holy man, a man of God, that he can heal. She finally has some hope. She comes to believe that if she touches his cloak, she'll be made well. So she comes up with a plan. She has to be secretive or it won't work. As Jesus comes through her town with crowds pressing in on him, she blends into the crowd, probably covering her face to conceal her identity, and she gets close to Jesus. She's behind him now, and she reaches out and touches his cloak. Will she leave a mark on his clothes? Is that something she worried about, that her blood might leave a mark and reveal what she'd done? Or was she mostly worried about the laws of ritual cleanliness? As one commentator puts it, by law, this woman's touch would have made Jesus unclean. And yet, by grace, the opposite happened. She was healed instantly. She felt it in her body and knew it in her mind and her soul. And Jesus knew it too. He felt the power leave him and he turned around asking who touched his cloak. Of course, the disciples thought that was unanswerable, considering how the crowd was pressing in, and they told him that, but Jesus kept looking around to see who had touched him. And this woman, who had been on the fringe of society for so many years, stepped forward. She fell on her knees in front of Jesus and told him the whole truth. As one who'd been unclean for over a decade, she went through the public humiliation of explaining in front of the whole crowd why she had touched him and how she had been instantly healed. And that could have led to some severe punishment, but Jesus didn't let it. Instead, he uses the word daughter when he speaks to her. And with that one word, the pain and isolation of 12 years vanishes. By calling her daughter, Jesus restores her to her family and to her community. He makes sure that everyone hears. Right there, in the middle of the crowd, he says, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." He makes sure that everyone hears him declare that she is healed, that she is no longer unclean. Her body is healed and she's restored to her community. He makes sure that everyone hears him say, "Go in peace," making it clear that the crowd should be kind to her. There should be no punishment for her having touched him when she was unclean. And when he says, "Be freed from your suffering," I imagine tears of joy and relief flowing down her face because both her bleeding and her isolation are over. This is a situation where healing means so much more. It's about so much more than physical healing. She can be an active part of her family again, an active part of her community again. With this healing, this restoration, Jesus leaves an incredible mark on this woman's life. No longer living in isolation, she is now freed to leave a mark on the lives of others. And yes, I'm willing to bet that she gave people hope after this, telling them about Jesus. And I'm also willing to bet that that isn't the only mark she left. Now that she was able to live as part of her community again, she could walk with friends and neighbors, supporting them in their own struggles. She could care for and help provide for her family. She could be an active, contributing member of her society. Truly, this healing meant so much more than physical healing. If you've ever been in the hospital or had a loved one in that situation, you know what I mean. When you're isolated because you're dealing with a medical condition, it's a lot. Being alone in the hospital is hard. And once you're able to be back home with family to finish recovering, it makes a world of difference. Connections make your physical healing go faster, and being restored to your community again makes a huge difference. You can give and receive love in ways you couldn't do when you were isolated. You feel useful again, and that sense of purpose spurs you on to get even stronger. When you've gone through a healing process of any kind, physical, emotional, mental, that healing can mean so much more. When we feel healthy, we feel like we can leave a mark. We can leave a positive mark on our loved ones, on our community, and on our world. Friends, you are children of God. Like the woman in the gospel, Jesus calls you a child of God. Whether you've experienced physical healing recently or not, God's grace in Jesus has given you spiritual healing. You are loved. You are forgiven. You are spiritually whole in God's presence. And God can use you to leave a mark on this world. Children of God, Jesus has left a mark on you, the invisible tattoo of the cross. Christ's light shines through you. May you leave a mark. Amen.
We come before God to pray for our communities, ourselves, and our world. Gracious God, thank you for sending Jesus to leave a mark on us and on our world. We thank you that the healing of the hemorrhaging woman meant so much more. Wherever we need healing in our own lives, we boldly ask it in Jesus' name. Let Christ's light shine through us and use us to leave a mark on the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of compassion, your touch brings healing. Hear our prayers for Chuck, Jeanette, Sandra, Candy, Danny, Ardell, Chuck, Dolores, Mert, Kelly, Pastor Margie, Randy, Jovita, Pat, David, and all who are in need. We also pray for doctors, nurses, and healthcare workers who provide care. Turn wailing into dancing and weeping into joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all ages, we thank you for the opportunity our young people had to experience you in community and in creation at Camp WAPO over the past week. May their time at camp leave a positive mark on their lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of creation, your goodness is all around us. Multiply the fruits of the earth and lead us to care for what you have made. Walk with those whose lives have been turned upside down by recent floods and storms. Give them strength as they move forward. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of justice and love, bring peace between peoples and nations ravaged by war or strife, including Ukraine and the Middle East. Guide all world leaders to paths of justice and freedom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of eternity, comfort those who mourn today. Pat Nelson at the death of her daughter Janine, Janet Jacobson and family at the death of Janet's husband Paul, and Gary Baker at the death of his son Chris. As they remember your promise of eternal life, bring them to a place of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive all our prayers, O God, for the sake of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, we want you to know that your offerings make a difference. We purchased portable AV equipment during COVID for parking lot worship, and we continue to use it for outdoor worship today. For vacation Bible school, trunk and treat, movie nights, and all sorts of other events. Like everything, that equipment needs maintenance and occasional upgrades, and our offerings make all of that possible. Reminder that there are many ways to give. You can mail in a check, use the QR code in the weekly announcements, or give through the website. As we consider our offering today, we listen to a musical offering. Let us pray. God of field and forest, sea and sky, you are the giver of all good things. Give us glad and generous hearts that you might provide for those in need and bring healing to the world through us. Amen. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. All are welcome at the Lord's table in and through our Saviors. Now hear these words. The body of Christ given for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you. At this time, please serve yourself or someone else in your household with those words.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. Generous God, thank you for feeding us at your holy table. Send us now, strengthened by this meal, to leave a mark on this world, speaking out with courage, breaking down divisions, building bridges of understanding, and serving others in your name. Amen. And receive the benediction. The blessing of God, whose fingerprints are everywhere, whose love has marked us with the cross of Christ, who journeys with us and speaks to us still, be upon you now and forever. Amen.
Peace. Serve the Lord. We will. Thanks be to God.